for this awesome man and woman of God,
amen.
Bishop and Pastor Corey.
Amen.
Amen. I was honored and privileged to come. Amen. I remember last year she invited me, and for some reason I could not make it. And I saw all the Facebook posts. I said, I bet I won't miss no more. But nevertheless, I find it an honor to be on this panel of esteemed, amen, ecclesia that sits behind me. I thank God for my husband in his absence. Amen. He could not be here. He had to work. I wanted him to be here. But I thank God for each and every one of you.
Amen.
The household.
Amen.
On tonight, everyone in their respective places. We were given a time limit, and I'm going to stay. Bishop, when you get to about 14 minutes, just stand up, and that will be my cue. I believe in doing things decently and in order. But let me just take it, so if I talk fast, if I seem to be all over the place, baby, just grab a hold to your seatbelt, because I'm going to take you real fast, okay? Okay, so the thing for this thing right here is position to deliver. Now, that's
God,
the Lord dealt with
God.
Me. I like to stay and flow with the order of the house. And she gave us 1 Samuel 1:20. Now, this is really crazy right here, y'all. When me and my daughter, when I told her, I said, baby, hook up the printer so I can print out my message. Uh-huh. Y'all hear the devil coming, right? Don't y'all hear his footsteps? So let me tell you what happened. Somehow something got unplugged and my whole laptop just shut down right in as I had just finished putting the finishing touches on and everything like that. So I'm like, okay, well, it's going to be okay. Thank God for auto recovery. Somebody say auto recover. But don't you know when God wants to say something, don't y'all know that auto recover did not recover? But let me tell you something, that's all right, because I thank God that he has hit a word in my belly. To you on tonight. So actually I had 8 pages and I think I only ended up with 5, but nevertheless I'm going to go with that, and I just want you to just follow me quickly. If I seem to be going too fast, just hold on. Amen.
Amen.
So she gave us 1 Samuel 1:20 that says, wherefore it came to pass when the time was come about after Hannah had conceived that she bare a son and called his name Samuel, saying, because I have asked him of the Lord. Now we all know, or some of us may know, the story about Hannah. This happens to be my favorite passage in scripture. I preached a message one time, pushing for time when it's time to push. See, we don't have time to keep trying to grab and hold on to time. It's time to move forward.
That's right.
But God said, no, baby, I need you to go a different way. Because, see, that's the thing in today. You know, I'm not coming in here, and I'm not going to tell you, Evangelist Jaquima already, you know, took you through the process of when a woman goes to deliver. But the Lord dealt with me differently. He kept dealing with me with the cross. And I said, God, why you keep dealing with me with the cross? Now, let me tell you something. I'm going to go back and forth. Okay, first of all, Hannah, amen, the handmaiden, was the wife of Elkanah. Elkanah, amen, was a man of God. He was actually of the order and of the tribe that descended from, I believe it was Korah, who was a Levite. So, Elkanah had another wife whose her name was Penina. And Penina, which actually means, amen, it means a jewel or a pearl or something like that, or a rare jewel. And Hannah and Penina were both Elkanah's wife. Now, Hannah could not bear children. She could not bear, but the word of God says, see, I'm not even using this. See, that's how much that would work. Amen.
That's
so,
right.
So Hannah was, she was barren, but she was not barren because there was a curse in her family. She was not barren because she had sinned. She was not barren because she had a medical condition. She was barren, the word of God says, that she was barren because the Lord had touched Hannah and made her barren. How many
that's
of you,
right.
You look like you're not producing
that's
anything,
right.
But you know God's hand is on you. You look like you're not going
you
anywhere. Yeah. make that pilgrimage. And you know, Elkanah didn't even have to take his family. Now this thing right here intrigued me. Why did he take his family? Because really, he was the only one that had to go. But every year he gathered up his whole household, and you know, he took all his family. And I'm like, now this the word of God says, read the story when you get home. It's only maybe about the first chapter. Yep. And so it says that he would take his whole family. Why would you take your whole family with you year after year? And you know, this woman over here keeps taunting this woman over here. Penina keeps taunting, you know, Hannah, year after year, telling her, you know, see, this is what the enemy will do to make you feel like you don't have any purpose. But you got to know what God's hand is on you. See, then she kept telling her, look what God did to you. All she was doing was confirming. Look what God is doing through you. Because she kept telling her.
Come on, y'all.
She kept telling her, look what God is doing to you. See, the Lord, see, she told her, the Lord shut up your womb. And see, here I got all these kids. And she had about 10 kids. And Hannah, year after year, the word of God says that she was sore, you know, vexed and perplexed as she went to the house of God. Baby, hand me that towel right there. Amen. I appreciate that. And she went, and she would just go, and she was just vexed as she would go. But listen here, one year she got tired. How many of y'all tired? Are you tired of the devil telling you who you not? You tired of him telling him you ain't gonna never graduate? Are you tired of him telling him, telling you that you ain't gonna amount to nothing? You tired of him telling you, you know, telling you that you not nobody? You tired of him compounding the words that your mama told you, that your daddy told you, that they said I was stupid, they said I was ugly, they said I wasn't gonna amount to nobody.
Hallelujah.
I ain't got 14 minutes.
Hallelujah.
Okay, wait a minute.
Come on.
Okay, so listen here. Listen here. So let me submit to you that Hannah had a problem. Hannah had a problem with low self-esteem.
Come on.
Now here you are, baby. You the prize. This man said, Hannah, echo every other verse where it shows where Penina came to taunt her. Here comes Elkanah, comes to confirm her. Every time Penina, every time you read about where Penina came to tell her what she wasn't, Elkanah will come back and say, but listen here, baby, I love you more than anything.
Yes,
you see what I'm saying? Every time they made that pilgrimage and he gave to Penina and her all her kids, you see what I'm saying? The substance of meat, he always gave her a double portion.
Come on, God.
She always got more. And then one day, Elkanah, when they went on the trip, he just got a little vexed about this thing. But I submit that he should have got vexed a long time ago.
Come on,
if you left her
right.
Like that,
that's
first
right,
of all,
yeah.
You're a man in this situation.
Right.
Where was your voice at all along anyway?
Come on. My God.
That
my
was
God.
For free. I'm sorry.
Come on, God.
I went off on a tangent.
That's all right.
Okay, but anyway, this will happen. This will happen. This will happen.
God bless the Lord.
You see
bless
what I'm saying?
Lord.
She went up. She went up to the temple this time. She went up to the temple this time. And this time she said, wait a minute, enough is enough. How many of y'all ready to tell the devil enough is enough? Yeah, I gotta reach my purpose. I have to reach my destiny. See, what our problem is in the body of Christ is that we know that Jesus' return is soon to come. And so we are becoming anxious about if God is going to be able to fulfill the mandate and the word that has been declared by the word in our life. So we have a lot of us going out. We're getting husbands that God didn't say he was yours. And never, not only that, he didn't even find you. We're getting jobs and the sister said we're getting positions that God did not say. We're out of position, but we're talking about being positioned. To deliver. Now I looked up position.
Jesus, hallelujah.
But I looked it up from a whole different realm. I looked it up in a marketing perspective. And I actually looked up brand positioning. and brand positioning. And I just want to declare to each and every one of you, God has a brand on your life, and He is going to put you on display for the world to see His glory in your life. And brand positioning means just that. It means to target a market. It means to position something so that you know without a shadow of a doubt that it's going to be successful in that area. That's brand positioning.
Hallelujah.
Okay, so now here we go. So I said, okay, God, so now what do you really want me to tell your people? It all comes down to this, y'all. It all comes down to this, and I'm wrapping up and I'm closing right here. It all comes down to really, God is not positioning us to deliver. Oh, it got quiet. My mama wouldn't say you could have heard him. You could have heard her. Church of my Spion Kai. Right there. What you mean, lady? You just told me that all this stuff was in me, and then you're telling me that I'm not being positioned to deliver? No, baby. If you think that it is you that is being positioned to deliver, then I submit to you, and I'm not... Well, I really don't apologize. I'm telling you right now that you're working, you're operating out of the realm of the flesh. You're operating out of your carnal senses and all of everything that makes up your senses. If you think that it is you, no. Why do I say that? Because listen here, as God dealt with me about the cross, Jesus, after he died, you see what I'm saying? I know I probably lost y'all right there because you don't get it. But I need you to look at your neighbor. As a matter of fact, don't even look at your neighbor because that's a fleshly act right there. I want you to just touch yourself and look at yourself. And you know what you look like. If you got to close your eyes and see yourself, I need you to say, tell yourself, say, I'm the baby.
I'm the baby.
It says this. What do I mean? Well, man, I'm sorry if some of this is way over some of y'all head. And I know I'm going fast. But let me tell you, it says, for the earnest expectation of the manifestation of the Son of God. Wait for the manifestation of the Son of God to come forth.
Come on now.
We're not ready to come forth. That's why we can't be delivering nothing, because we will be delivering bastards. We will be delivering stillborn, because we still full of attitude. We still full of competition. We still full of mess. We still full of fornication. We still full of adultery.
Hallelujah.
And then we think we're ready. We think we're ready. We think we're ready. No, baby. We're not ready to. We're not positioned. But if you're in the spirit realm,
yes.
I'm not going to say that for everybody. If you are in the spirit realm of God, then now you have assumed the right posture and position to be delivered. You see what I'm saying? So God, now God can birth you out so that he can present you. You are the bride of Christ. So now God wants to present you to the bridegroom. I know.
Jesus.
I know this word is different
for
y'all.
Come on now.
We don't talk about the bride and the bridegroom.
Come on now.
We don't talk about being ready. You see what I'm saying? For the bridegroom. But that's where God has us. You see what I'm saying? That's the womb that God wants us to be produced in. The womb of the Spirit of God. Somebody said earlier, how do I get there? Oh, baby, you get there. By every time your flesh wants to rise up, you have to open up your mouth, y'all, and tell it, not this time. No, you won't get me right here. I submit it and I place it under the blood. See, that's the problem. That's why we're being defeated. That's why we keep walking in our flesh.
My God. Jesus.
Because we won't open our mouths.
Jesus.
You see what I'm saying?
Hallelujah.
And so now God has us, you know, he has us in the womb. And he's saying, I need to give birth to you. Because I need you to present you to a world that needs to hear about a Savior that can save them from anything, that can deliver them. You see what I'm saying? That can fill them with joy. That can give them the peace that they desire. Huh? Hallelujah. Amen.
Glory.
That
Hallelujah.
Is my message. Yes. It might have been more at all. It's probably wherever in computer right. space somewhere. But nevertheless, that is the place where God wants us. Yes. You're the baby. Mm. It's not you that's going to deliver. God don't need us to deliver. God don't need us to advance the kingdom. The kingdom of God is going to advance.
That's it. That's
the kingdom
it.
Of God is going to
that's
advance.
Right. That's
whether
right.
you help advance
that's
it or not,
that's
the kingdom
right.
of God is going to advance.
Yes, ma'am.
The Bible says that the kingdom of God is not meat nor drink.
That's right.
That's why we have to get out of our flesh, y'all, and get over into the spirit realm. So he can present you a glorious church
yes.
without spot, wrinkle, or any such blemish.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Amen.